Secretary, pwede bang pakikwento lang kahit kaunti paano kayo paano kayo napili? Kasi kahapon yata magpapayag kayo ng certificate of candidacy. Biglang hindi natuloy.
Oh, actually filed Tuesday 10 o'clock a.m. But I got a call Friday and I was informed that he asked me to be the new Secretary of Interior. When the President asks, you cannot refuse, you must serve. And it's been on my mind on what reforms need to be done. I've been in local government for 29 years and I've seen everything from crooked cops to good officials to bad officials, and I think I know what the reforms and what forward paths should be taken.
Secretary, what made you choose the cabinet post over your election visa?
Number one, I serve at the President's pleasure. My family and his family have been together for a long time. A lot of you will question about my brother and I being in the cabinet at the same time. But I think it is not a question of whether we are brothers, but whether we are competent enough for the job. And I think we bring to the table different skill sets, and I think local government is my forte. I chose this position because I know that I can make a difference and I have the trust and confidence the President to pursue such differences.
So, bakit po nag-withdraw din ng COC si Vice Governor at
Minatanin? It's a political arrangement between all the families in Cavite. It's a mutual agreed upon. The candidates have been chosen and all the leaders of Cavite united behind a single ticket.
How will your leadership differ compared to your predecessors,
Jensen? I have a long shadow to cover. Ben Secretary Ben Habilos was very good. He was very dedicated. He gave me a lot of insights. We had a two-hour meeting yesterday, and he gave me a big briefing on the ins and outs of running the department, and he told me the difficulties and the challenges that lie ahead. And then I think that coming from where I'm starting from where he came from, there are more forward paths that we should take, and I think I'm ready for it already.
Secretary, how do you plan to address the growing concerns on peace and order, insurgency, and illegal drugs?
It's not a growing concern, it's a continuing concern. It's a continuing concern. Crime statistics are actually down, drug hauls are actually up. Our main concern now is to set up a system of reporting, like a national 911 system that will benefit the entire country. What we have now is a mishmash of one city and one municipality having different systems. So we want to create an integrated approach into reporting incidences all over the country. And we're going to start with the terms of reference tomorrow, and we hope to be it out by June next year when the new term starts.
Secretary, ano nakikita niyo?
Oh, it's always the police force. It's always the police force. The police force is composed of a lot of very fine professionals, but there is also a lot of competition and politics inside, and that has to be addressed.
So it's the politics, not the rogue cops?
The rogue cops can be easily dealt with. It's a matter of enforcement. But the politics is much more difficult. You're talking about everyone is trying to find a perfect solution from imperfect people. That's the President's call. I will make recommendations, but it's the President's call.
Sir, clarification lang, recommendation para sa
I will make recommendations on structural changes into the police force, but it is the President's call at the end.
Structural, meaning
PNP chief, structure itself. I think we're top heavy. I think we need to streamline the organization. I think that there are many superfluous positions in the institution, and I think there's a lot of change to be done. Needed to be done.
So not necessarily.